We next speaker will be Professor Alexander Lukin, and will tell us about tuning the spatial controlled growth structural self-organizing and cluster assembling of two-dimensional ordered linear chain carbon nanomatrix during ion assisted pulse plasma deposition. I think it's
very it's long.
But you win also for the best background, as I told you. Okay, please. Please, you can start.
Okay. Dear colleagues, first of all, let me thank you for inviting me to attend this important scientific event. My today presentation is connected with our recent efforts in development of the carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials. Due to unique physical and chemical features, these nanomaterials represent one of the most intriguing areas of the basic and applied researches during the few last decades. Our current efforts concentrated on novel strategies for predictive programming the spatial structure and physics-chemical properties of the functionalized carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials. Our research is executed together with Department of Physics at Bilkent University, Turkey, and supported by the Russian Foundation of Basic Researches and the Turkish Research Foundation, TÜBİTAK. The objective of my presentation is to create awareness of functionalized carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials, their molecular structure and the geometries, new strategies for predictive designing their structure and the properties and how their use in future applications can benefit our society. Ideal one-dimensional form of carbon, carbon allotrope, the linear chain carbon named as carbine, attracted much interest due to advanced mechanical and electrical properties, including mechanical strengths predicted by to be an order of magnitude higher than the Z for diamond. Back in the 1930s, astronomers detected carbines as one of the first molecules in the interstellar space. Unique combination of extraordinary properties of the carbine-based nanostructured metamaterials offers a fascinating material platform for the development of the next generation technologies in many areas. This is super-fast electronics, ultra-sensitive sensors, multifunctional composites and coatings, membranes, medicine and biotechnology, energy storage matrices like batteries and supercapacitors, where the surface area of the electrode determines energy density. First of all, I would like to list the main key application areas for carbine-based nanostructured metamaterials. This is the electronic thermal protection system, functionalized carbon-based nano-sized additive can be successfully used for advanced energetic materials. Carbon-enriched metamaterials can be used for supercapacitor application. The next application is the next generation of solar cells based on carbide-enriched metamaterials. And carbide-enriched metamaterials can be used for multi-mission radioisotope thermoelectric generators. The properties of the carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials essentially depend on their spatial structure. Differently hybridized carbon atoms are capable to form diamond, graphite, linear chain, grids, and many other specific allotropes. Each carbon allotrope has notably different electronic and mechanical properties. The existence of the cosmic carbine can be used as a key to its formation mechanism and additionally confirms the presence of a factor of self-organization in the carbon chain's growth. Linear chains are present in carbon vapors at temperatures about 5,000 degrees Kelvin. The technology for growing this unique carbon nanostructured metamaterials is enough simple. It's self-organizes during condensation from carbon vapor in a vacuum at temperature about 3,150 degrees Kelvin. The electronic structure of the linear chain carbon molecule includes two kinds of bonds. The sigma bond provides mechanical stability to the linear chain carbon molecule, and the p bond, in addition to mechanical stability, provides the electrical properties of this nanostructure, since the p electrons are delocalized and belong to the interior chain of atoms. The growth of the microscopic crystals of the carbine is inhibited by the instability and high reactivity of this allotropic form of a carbon. Nanostructural stability depends from the linear carbon chain lengths. Most of current research efforts concentrated on searching possibilities for stabilization of the SP hybridized carbon chains. In 2016, a fundamentally new strategy was proposed and demonstrated to ensure the stability of the structure of the extremely long SP hybridized carbon chains through growing within the long nanomatrices formed by the double-walled carbon nanotubes. This result showed that the fundamental possibility of using the control of the nanomatrix structure for programming the stability of the carbon chains. One of promising roads for growing of the carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials is ion-assisted pulse plasma deposition from the carbon plasma. This technique was developed relatively recently and opens possibility for growing of stable carbine-enriched nanostructures in the composition of multi-cavity nanomatrices. Such nanosized carbon structures obtained the name as two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon, and which is a two-dimensionally packed hexagonal array of carbon chains held by van der Waals forces at the distance of about 5 angstrom. This technique also opens possibilities for further increase of the long carbon chain stability through assembling them by atomic clusters of different chemical elements, for instance, silver, gold, titanium, and some other metals. Due to understanding deposition possibilities like layer by layer deposition, possibility of metastable carbon phase synthesis, low substance heating, low substrate heating, applicability for various substrate types. This toolkit continues studied worldwide. The model of special structure of the two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon nanomatrix shows that the vacant functional nanocavity available for the nanoclusters assembling. Along the vertical axis, the electrical conductivity of the nanomatrix is metallic. Due to absence of coupling between the carbon chains along the longitudinal and transverse axis, where the van der Waals forces only exist, the nanomatrix demonstrate dielectric properties along this axis. Such kind of nanomatrix represent a multi-cavity nanostructure containing vacant functional nanocavities available for the atomic nanoclusters assembling. Cluster assembling of the nanomatrix can occur both without chemical interaction, so-called intercalation, and with rupture of the P bonds, which can lead to additional reaction. For instance, assembling two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon with calcium clusters, which suck up hydrogen molecules, creates a high-density reversible hydrogen storage device. The two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon nanomatrix could serve as the efficient basis for designing and growth of the new carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials with unique electrophysical, optical, structural, topographic, biological, and chemical properties. The cathodic arc plasma deposition is a physical vapor deposition technique in which the electric arc is used to vaporize material from a cathode target. The vaporized material then condenses on a substrate, forming a thin nanomatrix. The main components of the carbon pulse plasma deposition reactor for growing of the carbine-based nanostructures includes vacuum chamber, the pulse plasma carbon generator, the ion source for ionic stimulation, the target assembly with removable target material. The ion beam irradiation of the substrate surface forms bends in the attached carbon chains, which provide stabilization the growing chain ensemble. The design of cylindrical cathode of the main discharge can contain cylindrical rods from different materials, different metals, for instance, silver, gold, titanium, and other metals. A number of experiments show that SP1 bonds and SP hybridized carbon nanostructures are formed only in a very narrow range of optimal ion-assisted pulse plasma deposition parameters. Let's consider the examples of self-organizing and pattern excitation phenomena for the model experimental system. Self-organization and formation of surface patterns are the most pronounced when the growing system is supplied with additional energy and by nano-sized active centers. The transmission electron microscopy presented on this figure has shown that the structure of the film deposited without ion assistance. This is the pattern A. is homogeneous, while the structure of ion-assisted samples is heterogeneous. From this transmission electron microscopy images, we can observe excitation of the patterns, and the structure of these patterns depends, as we can see, depends from the energy of ion assistance. The transmission electron microscopy for case of assembling the carbon nanomatrix by silver nanoclusters have shown that at increase of the energy flux into the deposition region occurs decrease the average size of the active nucleation centers at a simultaneous increase of their numbers. This very this dependence can be very clearly observed from these four images that corresponds to the different energies of ion assistance. When taking into account the height, with taking into account the height sensitivity of the structure of a two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon to ultrasonic vibrations, we propose a concept of vibration-assisted excitation of self-organizing and pattern formation during growing of the carbine-enriched nanomatrices. Acoustic hologram generated in the nanostructure growth zone is capable of controlling the growth process, cluster assembling, and formation of chemical bonds. Acoustic waves cannot propagate in the low pressure environment. At the same time, the acoustic waves can be transmitted from the vibration source to the solid as mechanical vibrations with specific frequency. In the result, the substrate mechanical vibrations during the deposition could influence on the surface morphology and structure of the deposited nanomaterial. The model experimental system demonstrates how vibrations affect on the structures of the deposited model nanomaterial. As a model materials was used the amorphous selenium and crystalline tellurium. Amorphous selenium and crystalline tellurium thin films were deposited by frequency-assisted thermal deposition in vacuum. This is a new approach for preparation of thin films based on condensation of the evaporated material on excited substrate, at which vibrations with audible input frequencies are applied. During this material's deposition, the mechanical oscillations were applied to the substrate with input frequencies of 0, 15, 115, and 4,000 hertz. As can be clearly seen from atomic force microscopy images, the acoustic waves applied to the substrate results in morphological changes demonstrated self-organizing of the nanostructures. The acoustic waves applied to the substrate results in more significant morphological changes in the tellurium nanostructures in comparison with selenium nanostructures. Pattern excitation phenomena in the plasma deposition region is programmed by interaction of several competing mechanisms. In particular, through the thermoelectric convection excitation by the state of stress in the deposited nanomatrix and by self-synchronization of the self-excited oscillatory cells in the deposition region. Structural self-organization and pattern formation are the universal and key phenomena observed during growth and cluster assembling of the carbine-based nanomatrix at the ion-assisted pulse plasma deposition. This universal laws can be used to program the structure of the grown of nanomat. This universal law can be used to program the structure of the grown nanomatrix. Since the nanomatrix is acoustically sensitive material, we propose the technology for the patterning and control of the nanostructure growth onto acoustically excited piezoelectric substrate, assisting the plasma deposition of the nanomatrices with acoustic waves leads to patterning phenomena characterized by substantial lateral changes in nanostructure, thickness, and properties. Application of the inverse piezoelectric effect during the ion-assisted carbon pulse plasma deposition can be provided through the deposited piezoelectric layer. This piezoelectric layer converts the released electric energy into mechanical acoustic oscillations that propagating through the substrate and growing nanomatrix. Interaction between the inhomogeneous electric field distribution generated on the piezoelectric layer and the plasma ions will be the main energizing factor controlling the local patterns formation and the self-organizing of the nanostructures. Controlled patterning has promising potential applications, for instance, in surface engineering techniques, in flexible electronics, and the for the semiconductor industry.
Another 5 minutes, okay?
Different acoustic driving frequencies and the waveforms generated by the piezoelectric layers can be used for programming the required geometric configurations and sizes of the nanostructure of the grown metamaterials. Simultaneous application of the direct and inverse piezoelectric effect opens possibility for interactive ion-assisted pulse plasma growth, the carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials. For development of the promising technologies of ion-assisted pulse plasma growing of the nanostructured functionalized carbon metamaterials with programmable structure and physico-chemical properties, we propose a new data-driven nanostructures genome approach. In accordance with this approach, for every specific carbon nanostructured metamaterial, there is a specific set of universal relationships like growth regimes, structure, and properties that allows to predict the main characteristics of the nanostructures under design and the technological regimes required for their predictive growth. The dependencies responsible for self-organizing and pattern formation phenomena can be established through the multifactorial computational models obtained with using of the experimental data. In the conclusion of my talk, I would like to mention the most important points. The structural self-organization and pattern formation are the universal and key phenomena observed during growth and cluster assembling of the carbine-based nanomatrix at the ion-assisted pulse plasma deposition. Manipulating by the self-organized patterns excitation, we can provide controllable synthesis and programming of the properties of the functionalized carbon-based nanomaterials. The two-dimensionally ordered linear chain carbon nanomatrix could serve as an efficient basis for designing and the growth of the new carbon-based nanostructured metamaterials with unique electrophysical, optical, structural, topographic, biological, and chemical properties. Fundamental improvement of the technology for growing carbon-based nanomatrices is connected with application of the data-driven carbon nanostructures genome approach for programming of the spatially controlled growth, structural self-organizing, and cluster assembling of the carbide-based nanomatrix during ion-assisted pulse plasma deposition. Thank you very much for your kind attention. If you have any questions, I'd like to answer them now.
Thank you. Thank you. And very nice presentation and very nice pictures. Are there questions? Please, if you have a question, just write down in the question and answer.
If one has a question, I have one technical one.
Okay, yeah. Please go.
Thank you, Dr. Alexander Lucan, for the presentation. It is really interesting for me who works before with the plasma, but I'm wondering how we could stabilize the plasma between, it is a plasma, if I understand well. We are creating a plasma?
Plasma for stabilizing, in this technique, the main problem is provide stabilization of the structure of the nanomatrix. But as concerning the plasma flow, we can, many possibilities for control and stabilize plasma by magnetic rings, but this is not problem to stabilize plasma, but problem to stabilize the structure of the carbon-based nanomaterial.
Yes, this is my question is the uniformity against the plasma, and for sure when we will introduce the vibration for the substrate, because you told that you studied the vibration when you add a vibration to the substrate. I'm wondering how it could happen. It could be really challenging.
The application of vibrations during matrix depositions, this very new concept and work on under progress, and this phenomenon includes many interesting things that should be investigated in the future.
Yeah.
Because we can provide manipulating by the structure of this matrix with higher precision. We can create different patterns. This very promising technology.
Okay, we have the last question of the say, how the plasma frequency varies with the multi-dimensionality mm-hmm. of the carbon allotropies?
The frequency of plasma repetition, of course, provide influence on the structure of the materials. And as I mentioned in the presentation, there is a very narrow corridor where in which we can obtain the maximal content of the SP hybridized carbon in the matrix.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you for the nice talk.